this for us is one of the final steps of the journey.
No amount of years will reflect the trauma or the impact of the abuse, but we're just hoping for a just sentence.
Three sisters preparing to see their former principal finally face her fate.
It is she and she alone who should feel guilty and ashamed for what occurred. I am of the view that any such punishment must be a significant one.
County Court Judge Mark Gamble handing down his sentence, 15 years in prison, 11 and a half of those without parole. He described Malka Leifer's acts as predatory and insidious.
She continues to deny any involvement in the offences of which a jury has convicted her and has displayed no remorse. I am not convinced that Mrs. Leifer has in any way reformed.
Ellie Sapper, Dassie Ehrlich and Nicole Meyer have been waiting for this day since they first spoke out in 2008 about abuse from their former principal at an ultra-Orthodox Jewish school.
If they'd call me into office, I would just disappear and just not even be in that room anymore.
We were all hearing, this is good for you, this is going to be good for you when you get married.
Those allegations saw Leifer flee to Israel, where she feigned mental illness to delay being extradited to Australia to stand trial. This year, a jury ultimately found Leifer, 56, guilty of 18 counts of abuse against two sisters.
To finally be here today and hear those words, guilty, there are no words, really.
Today, the harrowing chapter in the trio's life finally comes to a close.
We wondered if this day would ever come and at times didn't feel like it would, so it's quite unbelievable that we have got here.
While no amount of years will ever be sufficient, we are so relieved that Malka Leifer is now in prison for 15 years and cannot prey on anyone else.
The courage of these sisters is something that can't be overstated. Mm. For 15 years, mm-hmm. they tried to get justice. And they've got it. It's quite interesting that the teacher, the disgraced former headmistress, has been sentenced to 15 years jail. But what really blows my mind is how this abuse was able to fester, and under the kind of veil of secrecy. They were raised in quite a strict household where there was no TV, no radio, no magazines, not a lot of internet, no kind of connection to the outside world. So for a lot of the time, that abuse to them, they weren't sure if it was wrong or not. They were told that it's good for your marriage, it'll be good for you when you get married, but it clearly wasn't the case.
No, and there were no words for it. And I think this is probably underlines the importance of sex education at school so that children can understand consent and understand when there's words. And it was interesting, the judge talked about the fact that these women received no formal sex education either at home or at school. So they had no understanding of human anatomy and didn't know the words for it. So how can you go and tell somebody what's happening to you when you've got that happening at home and no understanding of it at school? So I think you're correct, Sarah. I think they're incredibly brave to have fought this for so many years across different countries, different jurisdictions, and to not take no for an answer. It's extraordinary.
And then to get to the point of realising what they had to pursue in the first place. For national 24-hour counselling and support, you can call 1-800-RESPECT, so that number, 1-800-737-732.